Yo, Gassin here with a quick One Piece discussion video. I just want to do a quick top 10 of 10 things that I want to see in the Wano arc. Now I know what you're thinking, but we've already started the Wano arc, we're already in Act 2. That is very true, but my channel's only been around for a week, so if I'm going to talk about this, it's high time that I talk about it now and get it out the way nice and quick before any of this stuff happens or doesn't happen. Obviously, there's going to be spoilers in this video for anything up to manga chapter 936. So let's get into this. Starting off, I'd like to get into a new cover page story. The last one we got was the Grand Fleet, and currently we're going through the fan requests. While they're fun, I'd quite like now to get into a little bit more of the story, and the cover stories are a perfect way to deal with stuff that aren't important to the main arc. So what I'd like to do is to go back to Whole Cake Island and find out what's going on there and get answers to some of the unanswered questions. I'd love to go back and see what's happening with Katakuri and find out about the rest of the Big Mom pirates that haven't gone to Wano. What happened to Cracker? Last time we saw him, he was beaten up on the floor. Has he recovered? Is he even still a sweet commander? Also, we got loads of other unanswered questions, such as the Germa. Last time we saw them, they were being surrounded, and we don't know what's happened to them. That could be a cover story all in itself, but a hint or two in a cover page spread about Whole Cake would be nice. Also, we have Peckham's. Last time we saw him, he was getting his eyes gouged out. Is he alive? Is he dead? And speaking of alive and dead, what about Pound? We saw him getting executed by Oven, but this is One Piece. Crazier things have happened. So I'd just like a little bit of confirmation that Pound isn't another member of the Willoughby. Sorry, Pound, but I want you to stay dead. Also, another character we haven't seen in Wano is Prometheus. Is Prometheus back at Whole Cake? Surely Big Mom has to have some kind of representative in Whole Cake. So either Katakuri or Prometheus, or both.
Cool!
Next, I'd like a more antagonistic supernova. So far, Luffy has formed allies with two supernova, Capone Beige and Law. Capone was back in Whole Cake to take down Big Mom, and Law way back in Punk Hazard, and their alliance is the whole reason we're on this Kaido saga in the first place. But what about the others? So far in Wano, we have Kid, Hawkins, and X-Drake. But we also know that Scratch Man Apu is allied with Kaido, and because Kid's there, we can assume that Killer's there as well. What I don't want to see is for all of these characters to eventually become allies. Kid, I think, is a guarantee. He's already stated that he wants to take down Kaido. And I'd love to see another one of those scenes with Luffy, Law and Kid fighting to take someone down. Killer, of course, will come with Kid because Killer is a member of Kid's crew. But then we have Hawkins and X-Drake. Out of all of the supernova, X-Drake is the only one we know who actively went out to seek Kaido and join his crew. So there's a very high chance that he could remain loyal to Kaido. The rest literally had Kaido fall in their lap, and they either joined Kaido out of fear, or in the case of Kid, refused and got imprisoned. Killer again, we don't know what happened to him. There's a chance that he escaped, or he could also be captured just somewhere else in Udon Prison. Hawkins is the one I'm finding hardest to read. Out of all of the supernova in Wano that have joined Kaido, he's the one I can see betraying him the most. Mainly because of his abilities to look into the future, using his tarot cards. Maybe at the moment he's just playing the game, but eventually down the line we'll switch sides and join Luffy and the others. He definitely seems to want to catch up to Law, whether or not it's to capture him or just to have a talk, but he's definitely been letting him slip. Scratch Man Apu we haven't seen yet. I personally think he's going to be a subordinate of Queen, as his showman personality very much matches Queen's. But again, we don't know enough about him to really say what side he'll take. When we saw him in Shabaundi, he was the character that would fight from a distance, and was very quick to flee afterwards. So maybe he just joined Kaido out of fear. We definitely know he's working for Kaido, because we've seen him talking to the Beast Pirates on the Dendenmushi. I think it will be boring if all of the supernovas end up becoming allies to Luffy and Law. It will be a lot more interesting if some of them remained as antagonists. Obviously we know that down the road Blackbeard is going to be a big antagonist, and he is a member of the supernova. I'm talking about the rest of them. What actually I think might be really interesting would be if Killer is the one that actually sides with Kaido, and actually did betray Kid, and is the whole reason why Kid was in prison to start with.
Hachi!
Laura's pretty much been the main character since Punk Hazard. But what about the rest of his crew, the rest of the Heart Pirates? We've barely seen any of them, and Wano would have been the perfect time to see them actually do something. Unfortunately, as we found out in the last chapter, Beppo, Penguin and Sachi have all been captured, and we haven't seen anything to do with Jean Bart. So, what could they do? Well, finding out a little bit more about their powers would be nice. I've always joked with friends it'd be interesting if Penguin and Sachi, Sachi being named after an orca, a killer whale, actually had devil fruits, but Penguin accidentally ate the orca fruit and Sachi accidentally ate the penguin fruit. How these would look, I don't know, especially the orca one. Maybe he can just jump up in the air, turn into a giant orca and body slam down on them, whereas the penguin fruit would just turn into a giant Empoleon. And then we have Beppo. I'd love to see Sulong form this arc. Plus, we also know that Big Mom is in Wano at the moment, and Beppo's brother, Zeppo, was killed by her. So there could be some drama between them two later on in the arc, potentially ruining the alliance that Chopper is forging with Big Mom, thanks to her amnesia. Of course, for any of this to happen, they have to stop getting captured first, and being fodder.
Nana!
Speaking of Sulong, I cannot wait to see Inanarashi and Nekomamushi finally go into their Sulong forms, as with the rest of the minks. And when they do, I feel like it has to be against Jack. A straight up rematch will be awesome, and I don't want there to be too much outside help. If Jack's finally gonna fall, I want it to be versus them.
Roku!
Also in Wano, I'd like to see more development and find out more about Usopp's haki. We saw him unlock it way back in Dressrosa, but sadly we haven't seen much of Usopp or his haki since then, and I think this arc will be the perfect time to develop it more. What kind of form that will take, I'm not quite sure. It's obviously going to be more related to his sniping ability. I don't think it's going to be future sight like Katakuri, as that's more of what Luffy was training in. What I can see Usopp's being more like, it's just a grand overall awareness as where everybody is. Kind of like an early warning system like Nami in predicting the weather, and Usopp will be able to sense people coming from afar. And that could be very handy in detecting King. Bet the Big Mom pirates wish that they brought Katakuri with them when they went up that waterfall.
Go!
What I'd also really like to see is for Robin to get another battle win. Her powers are so interesting, and I don't feel like Oda has really used her full potential. In the Dressrosa arc, she took a sideline seat in the fight against Diamante, and essentially just became a big umbrella for Rebecca. It was pretty cool to see her fully protect Rebecca, while tanking the hit herself, but I want to see a bit more of this arc. And not just taking out the fodder like she always does.
Yawn!
And continuing to talk about the Straw Hats, at the end of this arc, I want a new Straw Hat member. Of course we got Jinbei, who's still got to come back at some point. He's already officially joined the crew. So what about someone new? Originally I was going to hold off on this until we got a little bit more into Wano, but looking at the characters that we're getting, I can't really see any of them joining up. So of course, one character that we still know is in Wano and played a big part back in Whole Cake is Carrot, and I still really want her on the crew. So at the end of this arc, please, Carrot for Straw Hat.
San!
Next, let's talk Big Mom. Okay, she's got amnesia, and currently she's an ally with Chopper, and she's going to Udon Prison, where she's potentially going to help Luffy or help free Kawamatsu from the prison, because we know that he's been rusted in, and we're going to need brute strength to get him out. But at the end of the arc, I don't want her to become a full-fledged ally. When she gets her memories back, I want her to turn. And turn back and turn everything around and become a problem for the Straw Hats and the rest of the Alliance. I'd really hate it if at the end of this, she regretted all of her bad decisions in the past. I want her to go full back into her old character and see her at her best and not just running around hungry, with amnesia, or as a joke. Will she side with Kaido? I'm not sure. Kaido really didn't want her in his territory. But for the good of taking down the Straw Hats, I can see them joining forces.
Nee!
At some point in this arc, I'm sure we're definitely going to get some Odin flashbacks. And when we do, I really want to see some Gold Roger flashbacks as well. We know Momosuke met Roger, so we'd love to see that scene. And find out more about Roger's time in Wano. If we're ever going to get some in-depth flashbacks about Roger's pirate crew, I think Wano is the perfect time for that, as we know he has so much history there. And it'd be great to see Raylene again when he was younger.
Itchy!
Of course, what I'm most excited to see is more about Zoro. This arc has to be Zoro's arc. The last arc was all about Sanji, and we got so many reveals about his past and his family. And I think Wano is going to be it for Zoro. We know from a recent SBS that somebody from the East Blue has ancestry in Wano, and surely that is related to Zoro. Also, looking at Ryuma, way back in the Monster Manga one-shot, he looks surprisingly similar to Zoro. Is that a coincidence? Maybe at the time it was just Oda recycling a character, but now I think it's definitely to do with Zoro's backstory. If we leave Wano without finding out anything else about Zoro, I'll be shocked. And just think how excited Luffy will be to find out that someone on his crew has the blood of a samurai. So there you go, 10 quick things that I want to see in the Wano arc that I just want to quickly get out there before we get too deep into the arc. What do you want to see in the arc? And what did you think of the things that I wanted to see in the arc? Let me know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed my video, like and subscribe. I do the manga chapter reactions and reviews every week. When there is one, so please check them out. I've been Higasin, and I'm going to slowly learn how to do endings. Talk to you later. Let's hit it. Yes!